Yeah, all right. Maybe too, Harry. Maybe that.
Let me just stop you there. We got more important business to talk about. And this is the wonderful collection of names that we got. I'm just gonna run them by you.
Faith plus one.
Plus one what?
Beefskate.
Not bad.
Asgard. This could take a while. Let me just rattle through them.
Yeah.
Okay, ready? Slam and Ram. Smash and Bash. The Sorcerer and his Berserker.
Oh, and the Berserker! Yeah, that's
Cheese and Onion. 1999's The Mummy, starring Brendan Fraser.
What's that?
I'll show you later. These ones are bad. Loser Bros and Asgardians. Power and Glory 2.
What about Power and Glory 2000?
This one's a bit weird. Vikings. It's apparently a mixture of Fife and Viking. You know, despite the fact that Alf Rardy and you're from Montrose. Asgard, sorry. There's a lot here, but I just don't think any of them's right.
No, I mean, they're not even. Look, they run right off. They're not very good.
It's not the right one.
No, they're not.
Right. Well, I did come up with something, actually.
Oh.
Team Brawl. Because, you know, brawling and fighting. And
Yeah, they brought
that. We come together.
That's not bad. Quite like that. But, how about this? I mean, there's a few skulls. There's a few skulls on here. What about Team Skull?
That's all right, but that's just you. Brawls both of us.
Yeah, I can teach you all about the skull. Everyone loves some skull. Skull! You know, everyone loves that.
Yeah, but I think Brawl's better.
Well, I think Team Skull is just a little bit better.
Brawl.
Skull.
Skull! Brawl!
Skull!
Brawl!
Skull!
Brawl!
Skull!
Brawl!
Skull! Brawl!
We've got a tag team name, we need a tag team finisher, we just need to speak to Alan, get it all registered up, and we're all good.
Ah, Slusher! Here I come! I've done it!
You've done what?
I've got all the paperwork done, we're all set, official team!
The team name?
Yeah, Skull Brawl!
Okay, that's not how you spell brawl.
Yeah, that's like skull, brawl.
That's not how you spelled it wrong, it's B-R-A-W-L. There's nothing we can do now. You've done it wrong. Always got to mess something up.
I don't know your words. You need to teach me the words.
Hello and welcome to All About the Disco. I am your host as always, Billy, as I bring you what's coming up in the world of Discovery Wrestling. This Friday, we've got a Friday Night Disco. It's Party and Porty. Let's have a look at the full card.
Testing. The 3rd of November is fast approaching, and Flying Ryan's ready for another Friday night disco in Portobello!
Whoa! What the hell are you doing?
Sorry, wait.
Why have you got this crap on?
So I'm just about to cut the best promo ever. Look, I've got a fancy microphone. I've even got one for you.
What?
There you go.
What do I need a fancy microphone for?
So folk can hear you.
You're gonna cut a good promo?
The best one in the world.
I think you need to have a good wrestling match first. Do you not realise that you have had the longest losing streak ever? Think about that.
It's fine. I've got a plan this time.
What a plan? What, you're going to go out and happy clappy dance about Flying Ryan? You've not won the last two times. Excellent Adventure. Ever since that point, it's been downhill. Do you know who you've got coming up next?
Yes.
Who?
I've got Dickie Divers.
Right. Who's Dickie Divers?
He's one of the best in the business.
Exactly. And you're going to go out happy clappy and Flying Ryan? I don't think so. Your plans haven't worked. So next time, like last time you never listened to me, but you're going to listen this time. Do your bloody job.
So Portapel Town Hall in Edinburgh will host the event, as it is a party in Porty. If you want to get your tickets now, they are still limited, but available at discowrestling.com. Find out plenty of options to get a ticket for the event. So we're going to go through the card here. We've got 6 matches announced for this show as far as of recording. If there's anything more announced, go check out Discovery Wrestling on social media. They'll be able to fill you in on what's going to happen and what's happening on the event to come. We'll have some videos, we'll have some little bits and pieces throughout the show while I lament and talk about all the matches that are coming up and why you should be getting a ticket. If you're nearby, if you're in Edinburgh, if you're within the vicinity of Portobello, you should be getting to this show. So let's just get into it. First up, we're going to take a look at Flying Ryan Griffin versus Dickie Divers. This is very interesting. Very interesting one. You saw the video there of Athena not being happy about Flying Ryan Griffin still being stuck in the past following Excellent Adventure. He's still stuck as Flying Ryan when we've known Ryan Griffin to be Griffin, and to have that weapon and that he uses along with Athena to torment his opponents, like Sekula Valhalla in the past, that he's been able to get under the skin of on shows. But recently he's been the happy-go-lucky Flying Ryan once again, and it's not been very fruitful for him, let's be honest here. But singles action, one-on-one, or just wrestling on his own, Dickie Divers hasn't had much luck either. Neither have got a win in singles action since February 2022. They've won in tag team matches, in 6-man tag matches, so they have victories under their belt, but they haven't actually been able to get a win on their own merit. On their own in Discovery Wrestling since February 2022. So that's going to be a bone of contention for both sides here. You've got Athena, who will of course be in the corner of Flying Ryan and will be trying to motivate him back into that that villainous streak that he has. But we may have Debbie Dahmer on the side of Dickie Divers, lots of D's there, as part of the Double D's. So will that cancel out Athena's influence when we have Debbie Dahmer there? Will Serena Rose be there in the corner of Dickie Divers? Dickie's got a lot of possibilities, a lot of people in his back pocket they could call upon to have in his corner, which could be advantageous. It could not be, because even though they do have a pretty good tag team record, he's still not a big fan of Debbie Dahmer as appearing in the Double D's, even though I think it's hilarious. It's great. Athena wants Griffin to do his job. So is this going to be a match where we're going to see two guys that are out to out shenanigan the other? Are they going to both use underhand tactics in order to get a victory? Are they going to both try to cheat to win? Or is it just going to be a straight out match? I doubt it. we're probably going to go for the underhanded tactics of both trying to outsmart and cheat the other. But I think it's going to make for a very interesting match. Who would win? So when you're looking at winners here, like I say, they both haven't had a singles victory in Discovery since February 2022, and I hope I've got my information right. If I have got it wrong, I'm so sorry, and just ignore the next little bit here. But if someone gets a win here, surely that's a big monumental boost to their standing in Discovery. Will that lead to them looking to tag team endeavors? Are we going to see Griffin and Athena go for tag titles? Are they going to move maybe into Griffin going and challenging the Y Division champion? Same with Dickie Divers. We would see a win here, launch the Double D's into a tag team competitive match, or would we see Dickie Divers and move ahead and try and unseat whoever the Y Division champion is at the end of the night? It's all about momentum. We've got to bear that in mind here, because like I say, I haven't had the win in a while in singles action. Do they have a claim if they get one win? We've seen people get title shots in other places and in Discovery with less wins, with just one win just to capitalize on and move momentum forward. So you can easily see that there. So that's it. Yeah, it's a very interesting match we're kicking off this preview with. Flying Ryan versus Dickie Divers. Who's going to win? Up next is a match I'm very excited to hear about and hopefully be able to see. I tweeted the Discovery Wrestling team not long ago about trying to see Discovery and get to see more online content. And it's, by the sounds of it, it is coming. We're going to see a boatload soon enough. So whether it's going to be a nice Christmas miracle, a nice Christmas treat for us, that we'll get to see some of the matches that I've been reading about and seeing clips of and photos of from the likes of David J. Wilson and Kyle Watts and getting to see those little clips in promos and all that kind of thing. I'm very excited to see this one, hopefully, when it comes up. It's Judas Gray versus Emerson Jane. Emerson, of course, has that title shot. Mentioned it in the last preview. She's got that title shot in her back pocket from the Disco Derby win. We don't know what title she's going to go for, whether it's going to be the heavyweight title, which, or the Y Division Championship, I should say, which is the one I think she may be going for, or the women's title, which is held before, or maybe tag team titles. We don't know. Emerson may have a tag team partner in her back pocket somewhere. I've said that twice, back pocket. Let's move on from that phrasing. On the other hand, with Judas Gray. Judas Gray is that unknown factor. He's always that unknown quantity. He's reckless in his actions. He's more willing to put more damage onto his own body in order to gain a win. And when you put that in with Emerson, who has done death matches, who is recently wrestled, made her debut for Impact Wrestling. She knows what risks need to be done in order to succeed. And when you come into that kind of environment, I think this was going to be a very spicy contest for that reason alone. Emerson Jane has had a little bit of a hand in the training of Judas Gray, so we'll know a little bit more about what Judas can do. Judas will have been taught some things, but he won't be taught everything that Emerson Jane has in our arsenal of maneuvers. Again, another just very interesting contest. So what if Judas Gray wins? If Judas Gray wins, what does that mean? Does that mean he should get a title opportunity since he's beaten the Disco Derby winner? Should he be challenging for a title? Does it mean that he has learned a lesson because he's got his issues with Ian Skinner? There's no word if Ian Skinner is going to be at the show. We do know that Gray caused some issues for Ian Skinner back in Livingston in September. So there could be some residual issues and resolutions from that point onwards. And all of that comes into effect of it's Judas Gray's birthdays. His birthday at this event. So will he be a little bit drunk on cake? Will he be a little bit too excited, a bit too eager to prove himself and make mistakes? He's still very young in the wrestling world. He's still young in general. Makes me feel old. Seeing him throw his body about and I struggled to stand up without my knees clicking. It just makes for a very interesting contest. Where are we going to see Emerson Jane continue her momentum after the Disco Derby win in July? She's got all this momentum in the world. I think she's going to make a debut in GCW very soon in the US. Whether it's going to mean more chances in Impact Wrestling or TNA next year, because she'll be over in the States. I hope so, because she's one of the best wrestlers in the country. Like, man, woman, whatever else you decide or feel that you are, Emerson Jane is one of the best in wrestling. And to see her getting these opportunities elsewhere and then coming back to Discovery Wrestling, it just makes for... Just you have to go see it. You have to go see the match while you can. You have to go see Emerson wrestle while she's still in the country and not in one of the big US organizations. You've got to go see her now, and in a match up with Judas Gray, you're going to be in for an absolute treat. Because like I say, he is reckless, but so is Emerson. They're both very willing to hurt themselves in order to gain a step ahead, an advantage. And it's going to be hard-hitting. It's going to be painful to watch. You're going to be sitting there and holding your back afterwards, because there's going to be a Shadowfax German suplex. There's going to be a Swanton. There's going to be some apron shenanigans, no doubt, as well, because Emerson's quite willing to do that. And Judas Grey, from all accounts, from what I've seen and from what I've heard, is very much on board with that kind of endeavor as well. So put me in for this as possible match of the night. Emerson has been putting on match of the nights wherever she goes right now, and putting her in with Judas Grey. It's going to be a match made in heaven.
What's it going to take, Aspen? Because the good times came to Livingston. Rob Stowe destroyed Caleb Valhalla. I outsmarted you both, and Monstrum absolutely decimated you. And your response is to go figure out a team name. Skull Brawl. And that leads me to come out into the... I don't even know where I am, looking for answers. Because if you won't take us seriously, then... If you won't take it seriously, then we can do what we want. We can just come to Party and Porty and destroy you again and again and again. Because if you won't take us seriously, then we've got the upper hand. Oh my goodness, good times indeed. I need to tell Rob. I need to tell Monstro. God, I was so angry before.
Manimal! Manimal!
Caleb.
Mighty Caleb is here, Manimal! Sorcerer!
Yes.
Sorcerer Aspen!
That'll be me.
Yes!
Yes, I'm phoning
Sorcerer,
you.
Sorcerer, I hear you! Where are you?
I'm phoning you. On your phone.
Oh! Through the magical hand device, of course, yes, very good!
That's the one.
Yes, I brought it with me! Right. I'm trying to find Manimal! He's lost in the woods!
What do you mean?
I have to help him!
Right, forget about Manimal.
I have to help Manimal!
Right, can you just please look at your phone?
It... Oh!
Hello?
How did you get in my magical hand device?
That's kind of how this works. You're in my one just now, and I'm in yours.
I'm how am I in your magical hand device?
This is how.
Am I lost?
No.
Am I lost, Sorcerer Aspen?
No,
help me!
Like
help, Manimal! I'm lost as well now. Here. Help!
Calm down, right? Just relax. Just chill out, okay? You all right? You okay there, buddy?
Okay. Okay. What are you here for?
Right. Okay, is that your
yes,
board?
Yes, of course I've got my skull board.
Perfect, because that actually works here. I've got a wee surprise for you, like a little gift, a surprise.
Mighty Caleb likes surprises.
Good, right, if you give me 2 seconds, right, and I'll get it for you, okay? Oh, look at that. Huh? What do you think?
It's beautiful.
It is beautiful. It's skull bro. Right, spelled the same way.
Skull Brawl! Yeah!
Perfect. Right. So anyway, I think we need to meet
anyways,
up
yes.
at some point. Talk about this tag.
Yes, hello! Yes, the mighty Caleb is very cold. Why do you ask?
Caleb.
Why do people keep looking at me?
It's probably because you talk less.
Maybe they know where Manimal is.
No, forget Manimal. Okay? Just completely forget about him. I think we need to meet up.
Yes, good idea.
Right. Because the good times, they don't think we're taking this thing serious.
But the mighty Caleb is always serious.
That's what I said. That's why. Look, we need to prove them wrong.
Okay. Good idea. Yes. What I'll do, I'll put you down.
No.
I'll put you down and I'll try and make my way back.
Right. Hang up the phone.
I'll find you somehow. Unless you want to come to the woods.
No, I'm not coming to the woods.
No, okay. I'll put you down now.
Right.
Put you down.
No. Caleb, hang up.
Right. Goodbye.
Caleb, hang
Goodbye,
up. The
sorcerer.
Caleb.
Okay, Manimal, I'm leaving.
Caleb!
I hope you're okay, I hope you're not
Caleb. Lost! Caleb!
Go!
Caleb,
go!
Get back here now!
Go!
Caleb!
Go!
Caleb!
Skull Brawl. We got a name for Caleb Valhalla and Lost Boy Aspen. They decided they didn't use any of the ones I suggested. I think I sent 10 names in, they're all awful. Although Power and Glory 2.0 did get a shout out in their pitch meeting for names, which I was very, very happy about, that at least one got in there and was mentioned. We've got Skull Brawl taking on the Good Times, Rob Stowe and Monstrum, with Mr. Manimal in their corner. This is... how to put this? This is... the Good Times are creepy. Let's go. Let's just pitch that straight away. The Good Times are frustrated at the lack of seriousness that Aspen and Caleb are proving or showing, as they're spending more time skateboarding or Caleb's getting taught the ways of Midgard, we're seeing laughing and joking on camera with Aspen and Caleb. And Manival is frustrated. He's got a team. He's got Rob Stowe, Messiah the Backbreaker in Scotland. We've got Monstrum as well, an absolute terrifying beast of a human. Or is he a human? I don't know. And they did this thing. They ended Joe Hendry's reign. They were directly responsible for Joe Hendry's mammoth reign of the Y Division Championship ending. You know, he was, they were very, they did the deed. They caused the DQ. They meant that Gene Money became the champion. And people don't seem to be taking them seriously. And they've picked a fight with Caleb and Aspen, stemming from Disco Derby more specifically. And from that point, they're just, yeah, they're not being taken seriously. Manival said, you saw in the video there, Manival it's cursed him that these guys aren't taking Stowe and Monstrum seriously. But in a snap of clarity, realized if Aspen and Caleb aren't taking their opponents seriously, then Stowe and Monstrum are free to do whatever they want. They're being underestimated by Skull Brawl. They're being underestimated. The good times are being underestimated by their opponents, so they can just do what they want. I mean, Rob Stowe defeated Caleb in September in Livingston. I mean, it wasn't without shenanigans. There was a post-match attack. There was all this thing going on between Aspen, Caleb, and the good times, which you would think would maybe snap some seriousness into Skull Brawl, but they seem to be still a little bit relaxed. I mean, this is a tag team that will save the universe. They have saved the universe at Excellent Adventure. They saved the wrestling world. There's no longer promotions on every corner. Thanks to Skull Brawl. But for this team to almost frustrate the good times, possibly into making errors, being overzealous in trying to prove that they are a monstrous duo, they might trip up, make mistakes. Caleb and Aspen have got a little bit of more experience. Aspen, probably the most experienced, well, he is the most experienced of this foursome. He's been around long enough, he's been in tag teams long enough as well to know what gets under the skin of opponents. And usually it's that Aspen kind of relaxed, not lackadaisical, but he doesn't show his cards. He doesn't go, oh, I'm going to do this to you. He quietly just undermines you a little bit. And to see him do that to the good times and causing Manival so much headache, because outwardly he's not taking them seriously, it's making me think that the good times may be in for a bad time on November 3rd at Porterville Town Hall for a party in Porty. Because we've seen Skull Brawl in action, we've seen the good times destroy and run through people. So this is going to be a very intriguing match. There we go. I think that's maybe the first time I've said intriguing on this show. So there we go. Intrigue count. Boom, one. It's going to be a match that I want to know about and want to see. So that's why I'm praying to the gods, to the Norse gods that Caleb knows well, I'm sure, that we get to see this match online sooner rather than later. It's going to be a great one. Skull Brawl and good times. Oof, it's going to be something.
Really perfect. I had it. It was in my grasp. I was nearly burnt.
Don't you dare. Well, a question for you, Zaki. What do you call yourself when you can't beat a paper champion? Does that make you a paper doll? You're going to stand up. I'm ready for you this time. You're going to slap. Oh, yeah. You're going to try and slap me from out of nowhere like you did the last time.
I'm not going
to
do nothing. Do you know why? Do you know why? Because
he is. You're going to do.
He is.
What are you going to do?
No. Don't you get my face, Randy? You hear me? Don't you get my face?
Hey! Hey! What's going on? Hey! You can step away. Step away. Hey, you. No. Step away. Step away from Randy.
What are you going to do?
Step away from Randy.
You're going to do Mr. Disco. You know what? I dare you. I dare you to do something about it.
Do it.
Use. Bam!
Hey! That's it.
This is good.
Last time.
Before we get into the tag team matches, Zach Dynamite is also in attendance. We've just seen the clip there of him attacking. Well, sorry, that's a lie. He wasn't attacking Randy Valentine. He sent Bruiser Brad Evans to do the job for him. This makes it all the more interesting, all the more intriguing for me. There you go. He lost to Gene Money in Livingston, so he didn't capture the Y Division Championship, even though he declared himself the number one contender de facto, because he was the last man standing in the Disco Derby before losing to Emerson Jane in the final two. He slapped Randy Valentine in an interview, and then after a little confrontation with Randy Valentine, he sent Bruiser Brad Evans to attack Randy until it was broken up by Alan Smith, Discovery Wrestling owner. Now, for those that are unaware, and I'm hoping you are aware, there used to be a tag team. There used to be a tag team in Scotland. They were a great team. And Zach used the word news in his goading after the attack on Randy Valentine when Alan Smith came to break it up. And that's what's piquing my interest here. So for those unaware, there was a tag team in Scottish wrestling called the Mega Pals. The Mega Pals were a team of Randy Valentine and Mr. News. Mr. News is Alan Smith, the owner of Discovery Wrestling. They used to be a tag team. They did some incredible promos, and they had some very entertaining matches as a team. I think they had one last match, and I haven't written it down. I don't have the information exactly to hand, but I think it was the All About the Raffle before the pandemic. I'm going to go double check live right now. I say live. This isn't going out live, but I'm just going to do it while I'm here, because I'm sure it was. Is that they have damn you cage match? I'm going to go check my own. There we go. Right. Yes, February 2020, Alan Smith and Randy Valentine had a match. The Mega Pals had a match. And I think that was the last time we've seen them as a team. And as much as Mr. News has always said, or Alan Smith has always said, he's retired. He always seems to be dragged out for one more. And we've seen Retro Randy come out from the shadows and return to the wrestling world through Fair City Wrestling and a little bit in Discovery as well. I think he was in Disco Derby. So are we going to see the foundation of the future eventually taking on the Mega Pals? Is that going to be at Party in Porty? Is it going to be in the near future? We know Zach Dynamite is in attendance. We know that Al Smith, of course, will be there. We don't know if Bruiser Brad is. We don't know if Ryan Riley is going to be there. And we don't exactly know if Randy Valentine is going to be there. I assume he's still in commentary, so he may still be in attendance there as well. So could this volatile situation lead to foundation of the future taking on the Mega Pals? Or are we going to see a new version of the Mega Pals where Mr. News recruits a new partner for Retro Randy? And who would it be? Who would be that partner? Are we going to see, I'm trying to think of anyone that off the top of my head that could fit into that dynamic, a bit of retro. Are we going to see Tom Fulton come back? Are we going to see something like that? It just makes, I'm so interested. So I need to know. I need to know where we're going to go from here. I know I'd love to see, actually. I'm just scrolling through names here. Sam Barber Experience, SBX. I think he would kind of fit nicely with Retro Randy's kind of aesthetic style, a little bit flash, maybe something like that, possibly. Just throwing that out there. But yeah, I don't know what's going to happen. And that's the best thing about Discovery shows, especially Friday Night Disco coming up, that we don't know what's going to happen, and we're going to possibly see some sort of escalation here between Retro Randy and Zach Dynamite. Will it just be a one-on-one match? I don't know, but I'm really, really interested to see if we're going to see the return of the Mega Pals. So let's go look at the tag team, the tag team championship and all the rest of the championship matches that are coming up on Friday. First up, I mentioned the Discovery Wrestling Tag Team Championships and my fluster there. Kings of the North will be defending against the Dangerous Brothers, BT Gunn and Kez Evans, in a match that was due to take place in July for Disco Derby until Kings of the North had to pull out of the event. On that show, Evans and Gunn defeated the Fair City Saints, so they still have their claim to the Tag Team Championships. Whether that could be as a de facto number one contender match or continuing to be the number one contenders because of that victory, we can say that as being the case. We've got them coming in, BT Gunn, Kez Evans. I mentioned in the Disco Derby preview, I think, that this is a team that may not be as experienced in the ring as a team, but they've trained together. They've wrestled each other. They've had some bloody feuds as well. So they are very familiar with each other as a team. Coming in with Kings of the North, Kings of the North are a very experienced team. They've won titles just about everywhere they've went. With titles like they're holding now in Discovery Wrestling, but they've held titles in TNT, they've held titles in ICW, they've held titles, I think, in Progress as well. So they're well versed in tag team wrestling and winning titles, continuing to hold titles as well in defenses. Kez, I don't think he's ever won a tag team title. He's won world titles, Zero G championships, and he's very well versed right now and highly regarded. His recent, I think he's been in the PWI, Pro Wrestling Illustrated 500, about 3 years in a row now. So he's still a very highly regarded wrestler and decorated in accolades as well as titles. And then you've got BT Gunn, who has won tag titles numerous times with some fantastic partners, including Stevie Boy Xavier, who's just as was a phenomenal high flying tag team. The Dangerous Brothers won't be that. And they're coming up against Kings of the North. This is going to just be barbaric. This will be, I like saying, survival of the fittest. I think that's going to really be the factor here. Kings of the North are over 1 year as Discovery Wrestling Tag Team Champions. They surpassed that in July. So a sliding doors moment. We could have been the case of if that match took place at the Disco Derby, Kings of the North wouldn't have passed that year if the Dangerous Brothers were able to capture the titles on that night. So they've surpassed a one-year milestone, but is it tainted? I think they need to beat Dangerous Brothers to prove that 1 year, not wasn't a fluke, that's probably not the best way to put it, but it wasn't, they passed 1 year, but they didn't earn that 1 year in respect of they should have had a match at Disco Derby in July. And if they won it, then past the year, great. But they pulled out of that show for whatever reason. I don't know if it was medical, whatever. But they didn't attend that show. Therefore, they passed it without a challenge. They passed that 1 year point. So I think they need to win. They need to win here to prove that 1 year, to complete that 1 year. Even though it happened in July, I think they need to win here to complete it. They've beaten some big tag teams, beaten Wild Lions, Sunshine Machine. They've beaten some very willing and confident tag teams, and I think they're going to meet their match here, because a lot of the time, Kings of the North, speaking of Wild Lions, actually, that's probably a very, very brawling, like, barbaric team in itself. They're quite heavy, power based, much like Kings of the North are. But the Dangerous Brothers are going to have that, and they've got a bond. Wild Lions were kind of fractured when they came into the tag title match, but the Dangerous Brothers, Gunn and Evans, they are got a common goal. They're here to destroy, and they're here to win. And this is going to be, and I would say, I've said what I think is going to be the match of the night. I think it's going to be Judas Gray and Emerson Jane. But put this down as a dark horse of the match that people are going to be speaking about when this event ends. People are going to go back and go, oh man, Kings of the North and BT Gunn and Kez Evans, wow, there was a lot of chops. There was redness all over the place, and possibly we'll be seeing new tag team champions. For me, I wouldn't be against it. I wouldn't be against it at all. If we're looking at three championship matches here, I think this is a good shot. The Dangerous Brothers picking up the win, and maybe even if they don't pick up the win, I think they're going to make sure the Kings of the North know that the Dangerous Brothers were around. into the second of three title matches. We've got the Discovery Wrestling Women's Championship. Casey defends against Daisy Jenkins. Daisy Jenkins defeated Emerson Jane back in June. To get this match. It wasn't outwardly put that it was the number one contenders match, but I think that beating a wrestler of the caliber of Emerson Jane really puts you into that contention for being a champion or getting a championship match. Coming up against Casey, who hasn't defended the title that often. Won the title about two years ago. I think it was about the end of when the shows came back, around about that time. And she hasn't, I think she's defended it once against Emerson Jane. And she had some tag team run with the She-Wolves for the tag titles, which they didn't win. And then she injured as well, broke her wrist. So she had quite bad luck during her near 2 year reign as Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion. And for me, if look at the tag, I talked about the tag titles being probably a good shot at the Dangerous Brothers maybe picking up a win here. I think if there's any chance, any time for Daisy Jenkins to win a title and become Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion, this is the night. Friday Night Disco, Party and Porty, Daisy Jenkins becomes Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion. Casey's run in Discovery has been, she's not been lucky. That's probably the best way to put it. She's not been lucky through injuries or having to, mainly injuries, because she's had to use Moxie Malone, she's had to use Molly Spartan, either as stand-ins or as an advantage, as a distraction or any of that kind of stuff. And she just hasn't had a good run, like a good run of matches in Discovery since the shows came back. And Daisy Jenkins is, like I said, this is the chance. If she's going to have a chance, this is the time to do it. As far as the match goes, these guys are a little bit familiar with each other. They've had a few matches. I think they wrestled quite recently at Iron Girders as well in a triple threat match. I think Casey picked up the win on that night to move on to King of the Fling match. But I think this is it. I think we're going to see Daisy Jenkins as Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion. Call it intuition. Call it a gut feeling. And my gut is, yeah, it doesn't have a good track record of being right. But I think, I believe that we're going to see Daisy Jenkins as Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion at the end of that match. And another match that you could possibly put down as another dark horse for match of the night, much like every match I've gone through so far, there's going to be something for everyone on this show at Party and Porty on November 3rd. And this is going to be another match that I'll want to know who wins as soon as possible. I want to see, I'll be keeping an eye on social media. Go to at Disco Wrestling on Twitter, X, Facebook, Instagram, wherever I need to see it. I want to know who wins this as soon as possible. And I'm believing that we're going to see Daisy Jenkins become Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion. And we're all going to be on board with the Daisy chain with it as well. So this is a very, I think I've just put way too much pressure on Daisy, and I apologize for that. But she'd be a wrestler that I've seen grab opportunities and take advantage of the opportunities and make the most of any time she's got in the ring, whether it's leaving an impression if she doesn't pick up the win. You certainly remember Daisy Jenkins by the end of it, through her maneuvers and through her attitude and everything in between. I think this is it. I'm putting out there, I think I've said enough about that, haven't I? Putting out there, Daisy Jenkins, Casey, I think we're going to see a new champion. And finally, Discovery Wrestling Y Division Championship match. Gene Money defends against Andy Roberts. So this is the third time for Andy Roberts, or I think this is the first time as Andy Roberts. He's had three singles opportunities for this title against Joe Coffey, Joe Hendry, and now Gene Money. So he had a triple threat as well, which was Joe Hendry, BT Gunn. But we're going to stick with the singles matches. So he's had three. This will be his third opportunity at this title. And Andy Roberts, Andy Wilde. It's going to be a lot of confusion here. Andy Wilde defeated Gene Money in October 2021 when Disco returned. So Wilde was able to beat Gene Money. Andy Roberts doesn't really believe Andy Wilde is the same person. Andy Roberts thinks he's the upgrade. He's the real version of what Andy Wilde was supposed to be or trying to be. So if he's beaten once, by all accounts, you think that if Andy Wilde could do it, Andy Roberts should certainly be able to win the title and become Y Division champion. And you look at Andy's accolades in Discovery, certainly. Disco Derby winner, Hotter Than Hell Invitational winner, but he's never won a belt. He's never become a champion. He's had tag team title opportunities as well. Mentioned it before, Wild Lions. He's had shots at the Y Division Championship. Current UEWA European Heavyweight Champion. I mean, that's a record-breaking reign. I think it's about 1,500 days he's been holding that title. But surely a championship that he's chased for a long time now in Discovery Wrestling, he's had his chances. He's won every opportunity he could to get a title match, win that Disco Derby, winning that Hotter Than Hell Invitational. They were all opportunities and working his way to getting a title shot. And to see him maybe capture it on this night, they say third time, possibly a charm for Andy Roberts. If he doesn't win, though, what's next? Does he go back to the bottom of the pile? Does he have to work his way back up? Does he try and force his way into a fourth match over the Y Division Championship? There's one win each as the show's returned for Andy Roberts and Gene Money. One win. Would it make one win each if Gene Money defeated Andy Roberts at Party and Porty for a night disco? So would it be 1-1? Would there need to be a rubber match for Andy Roberts and Gene Money to determine who is the best? That's the interest. That's the intrigue. There you go. I think it's the third time I've said intrigue. It makes it interesting. I don't know. I think Gene Money is fantastic. Especially the last couple of years, he has become one of the most all-round fantastic wrestlers in the country, in the UK. And his title win was a bit tainted. I think from that point onwards, Gene's done all he can, he's doing all he can to prove it wasn't a fluke, because the good times interfered and meant that Gene won the title from Joe Hendry. I think that there's always going to be a little bit of a chip on the shoulder of Gene Money because of that, because he didn't win it outright, even though he wasn't part of the good times. The good times weren't employed by Gene Money to do so. There's always going to be that chip on the shoulder there for Gene to prove that his title reign is legit. He's not a paper champion, as Zach Dynamite called him. And Andy Roberts, he's got one of the biggest chips on his shoulder right now because he feels like he is due something, anything, from anyone he works with, from everywhere he works with, because he is, in his own mind, one of the greatest wrestlers going today, one of the best heavyweights, one of the greatest sports entertainers that's coming in here. And he feels like he deserves the Y Division Championship. He's beaten the big lads. He's beaten the little lads. He's beaten anyone and everyone. He has given, or at least left an impression on physically on everyone that's come in the ring with him. And to see these two big lads face off one more time, I don't think it's going to be a party. I think Roberts is going to end. We're going to aim to be the party pooper in this situation, and try and make this as quick and possible, as painful as possible for Gene Money to become Y Division champion. Prediction? I think Gene, but I've already said I am terrible at predictions, so don't take my word as gospel. I know nothing. My voice is dying, as you can hear, because I've just talked about why my thoughts and feelings about every single match here, and my predictions are terrible. So don't take that for granted. Don't take that as gospel, like I just said. But I think Gene Money possibly will walk out of the show party on November 3rd, still Y Division champion. Only Andrew Roberts can prove me wrong. So that's it. Six matches on the show. We've got Zach Dynamite possibly causing a ruckus as well. Friday Night Disco Party in Porty, November 3rd. Port Bell Town Hall in Edinburgh. Tickets are still available. DiscoWrestling.com. This looks like a fantastic show, an absolute fabulous show. And if I wasn't in the northeast of Scotland and was able to attend, God damn it! Soon as I'm able to attend the Discovery show, I can't wait, because getting to see these shows online, when they go up, getting to see the reactions, getting to hear about the shows, they just make me more excited to go. So eventually, 2024, I'm making it my aim. I will be live at a Discovery Wrestling show. That's the plan. That's the hope. Fingers crossed. But for now, this has been All About the Disco with your host Billy. Hope you've enjoyed. Hope you're going to the show. If you're not, and I've convinced you to buy a ticket, let me know, just so I know that this isn't all just me rambling for half an hour, 45 minutes into the ether of nothing. But in the meantime, have a good one and go wild. It's a Friday night disco on Friday on November 3rd at Port Bell Town Hall. Go have a party in Porty.